Okay. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. I'm so excited. I'm so excited. I just feel like the presence of God. I feel the anointing of God. And you know what really gets me excited is this is the only outlet some of us have the whole week. Everybody's inside. So it's a very special moment and very special time to share together. Thank you, my brothers and sisters in the Philippines. I love you all. I've been there 3 times, but the Philippines is very precious to my heart. And the Filipino people, your president, your boxer, everybody in the Philippines, so beautiful, beautiful people, beautiful hearts the people have, beautiful children, the country. You're a very beautiful country. I live in Wisconsin. If I would, I suppose I could show you real fast what it looks like outside. And so it's cloudy today and it's cold. Here's my message today. And when I am done, if you want, I have anointing oil and I can pray for anyone if you like. My heart is to do God's will. I'm God's humble servant. My title is Brother Mark Samuel. My title I'm preaching on today is called A Virtuous Godly Woman. And underneath that I have God desires such a woman. Now, especially the ladies today, this message is for you. But it is for everyone. In fact, I have a part 2 to this message for next week if I get a chance to preach it. But I'll tell you something. God loves a godly woman. Jesus Christ died for a godly woman. It is so precious when you're a human being. But when you are godly, it's like you are just 10 times more precious. God looks at the heart. Even when you're singing and you're talking, and maybe I don't understand the dialect, let me tell you something. I understand the heart. I hear the heart of God in the ladies, in the men that speak. That's what's important. So I want to say that to you, that God hears your heart. God loves your heart. And may I say to you, through this virus, through this troubling time, let me promise you from America, I'm telling you, this is a precious moment. What Satan meant for evil, God is going to use this for good. Already, many souls are coming to the Lord through this. Many people are turning their lives to Christ. They're seeking God, even coming to internet places like this. People that don't go to church, they're finding these sites and they're getting excited. They're finding Jesus Christ. You're going to hear many stories later on, I think. I'm telling you, this is exciting. God spoke to me before this started that God is dealing with the hearts, and that the good news is this is going to pass. And my prayer and my word to all pastors is pray in Jesus' name, virus, go. Chinese virus, you cannot stay. We cast you out of the land of America, of the Philippines, of Germany, of Russia, all over the world in Jesus' name. And when we're done, we'll pray. Let me start, though, with prayer. I'm going a little bit ahead of myself. I want to start in prayer. Father, in Jesus' name, oh God, you've already anointed me, but Lord, anoint this message. Bless each one that's here. Bless my brothers, my sisters. Let them even share this later on during the week. Let them be, Lord, a blessing. Let this blessing go through them and to others. And bless their children, fathers, mothers. Lord, let all the women be blessed with the being respected and be honored as mothers. All their mothers in Jesus' name. And Father, honor their mothers. All of us that have mothers, honor them. Oh God, there's some great mothers because they love you and they love their children. Oh, it makes me want to cry. Praise the Lord. In Jesus' name I pray. Amen. Amen. I will try to get through this. I am just so excited. The anointing of God is upon me. So I am giving you a message for a virtuous woman. And this can apply to men, but a woman is special. She has a place that's totally different than a man, and yet they work together. This is all good. This is the way God does it. And a woman's place, especially when she has a husband, it will be to cover the husband. The powerfulness of a woman that covers her husband is so magnificent. It's so powerful. Because a man is when a man has a woman that's covering him, it brings him to a place closer to God. God hears the heart and the voice of a godly woman. God hears the heart of a godly woman. Your softness, your boldness, your firmness, your strength, God sees. And God loves and God uses. So I am going to start in Romans chapter 16. I will try to go not too fast so you can understand me. Verses 3 and 4. I will read it and understand something. God uses simple people. I'm simple. I'm nothing special. And God made my voice to speak. I love to speak about God. So if you love to speak about God, don't be shy. Hallelujah. So Romans 16, and I'm just going to read this. And I'll explain why I'm reading this. It says, this is Paul. He says, greet Priscilla and Aquila, my helpers in Christ Jesus, who have for my life laid down their necks. Laid down their necks means you sacrifice yourself. You're willing to cut your head off. You're willing to sacrifice yourself, to give yourself. They've laid down their necks, unto whom not only I give thanks, but also all the churches of the Gentiles. Now, what I want to read this for is one reason. The thankfulness Paul had for the women of God at that time. This is the New Testament time, 2,000 years ago. That is a picture of what we are supposed to do. If you know men that are not thankful for women, you know what? Pray for them. Men especially need to thank God for women. That the earth, the men would not be here if it wasn't for women, for one thing, praise God. But in the spiritual, women are used very quietly usually to support the ministry of men. And many women are used in ministry and preaching and working of God. God has a special place for a woman, and I tell you, it is very special that we honor one another. And I honor the women today, this day, Mother's Day. And so that is the verse I wanted to read, that is something. So I'm going to go from there, and I'm going to go back to Proverbs from there. And so this is going to be Proverbs chapter 31. But wishing, a virtuous woman is my message. This is what I'm talking about. And let me just read a couple things I have here. A virtuous woman, I want to give you the definition. It's one who leads her home with integrity and discipline and much more. And she is making choices that will bless her husband and teaching her children to serve God. Now, there are many women, of course, that don't have a husband for whatever reason, and you have children. Or maybe I'm talking to some that have no husband, no children. This applies to you all. We all can be you can all be virtuous women. And so you have integrity, you have discipline, you raise your kids. She is making choices that will bless her husband and teach her children. This is a godly woman. This is what God wants a woman to do, to strive to be that woman that blesses other people. And even a mother, an older mother, can help other young women to hear God's voice. So hearing God's voice, that is what the older ones can do. You know, the Bible speaks about with the older one, go with the younger one. And women with men, and I mean women with women, men with men. And so we are to help younger women, older women to help younger women in the Lord. Isn't that wonderful? And older men to do the same with younger men. To discipline and to disciple younger, that is the calling of God. America doesn't do a great job at that. And maybe through this virus, that's going to change. But we need to help younger, and the older need to help the younger. It's a perfect thing God wants it to do, to help them to grow in the Lord. Hallelujah. And to be good mothers, wives, and daughters, and so forth. So I'm at Proverbs 31 now. And so I'm going to start at verse 10. But let me just say, verses 1 through 9, it seems like it's a whole different book. It's talking about a king, Lema, and he's just talking about different things. And then all of a sudden, it's like, you ever go down, walk someplace, and all of a sudden you come around a corner, and it's beautiful. All of a sudden the sun is shining, and you see something beautiful, maybe a waterfalls. You got beautiful places. This is what this is. You're reading, you come to verse 9, no big deal, it's interesting. And then verse 10, all of a sudden, it's wide open to something brand new. To honor the virtuous woman. This, now, the next verses, verses are going to be 21 verses, will be honoring the woman and speaking what an anointed virtuous woman is. So let me read here. Who can find a virtuous woman? For her price is far above rubies. The heart of her husband. Now, let me just say, rubies is a very, that is like gold. It's a lot of money. So her worth is good when she's virtuous. The heart of her husband does safely trust in her, so that he shall have no need of spoil. And so that is a good relationship. When you have a husband, and again, my message to all women, but if you are married, then this especially to you. When you have a husband, it is far more powerful, because that when she honors her husband, that makes him a better man. That helps him to be a man of God. And so the heart of her husband does trust in her, so that he shall have no need to spoil. So he doesn't waste anything, it means. Spoil is, it goes bad. He doesn't spoil because she is there to support him. So I'm not sure I got all this. I don't see everybody. But if I can't change it, then I can't change it. I'm just seeing the people writing things. Oh, okay. No, I see. You got Proverbs up there. Okay, very good. Very good. I gotcha. Very good. Okay. I'm sorry. I thought those were notes. She seeketh woe. Let me go to the verse before. She will do him good and not evil all the days of her life. You know, there's a lot of wonderful women, and then later on, they do fall into sin. And men could do the same, of course. And later on, they are not such a blessing, and that's sad. God wants a woman to be a blessing all her life. So, verse 13, she seeketh woe and flax, and worketh willingly with her hands. So, what it means is, she doesn't do it because it's a labor. She doesn't do it because it's her job. She does it because she wants to. She wants to please her husband. She wants to please her children. She wants to work with her hands, and in this case, to make things, clothing and stuff. She is like the merchant's ship. She brings her food from afar. She rises also while it's yet night and giveth meat to her household. And a portion to her maidens. So this is a very kind lady. Again, this is a picture of what God wants all the women of God to be. That she is not only kind to her family, she's kind to complete strangers probably. She's kind to the maiden, the one, the house, that keeps the house, somebody that works for her. She is kind, so she knows how to go beyond just the family. Okay, verse 15. And so she rises early, and then verse 16. She considers a field and buyeth it with the fruit of her hands, and she plants a vineyard. This is much labor. This is a story. I believe this is a true person. I believe this is a real person. She did everything right. And it's a beautiful picture of us to have example. And she planted this vineyard. And she planted, and she did things like she put a vineyard in it, but she worked the ground. This is a lot of work. There's no limit to what she can do. And so in verse 17, she girded her loins with strength and strengthened her arms. Now, let me just show you something in Ephesians, verse 6, chapter 6. And I just read this. It just take a moment, so don't change. What it is Ephesians chapter 6, verse 14. And it says, stand therefore, having your loins girt about with truth and breastplate righteousness. But your loins girt about with truth. What is she doing here? This is always, the Old Testament is a picture of the New Testament. And the New Testament is always a snapshot in the Old Testament. And this right here is saying that she girded her loins. Her loins are right there, around the back, lower back. And your muscle in the back is your strength. The lower back has the strength of what you do with your whole body. If you are a cripple in the back, your whole body is weakened. But with that, she puts a loin around her, the strength. It's this extra strength, a cloth. And that is what she does. This is, it's a revelation. It's so wonderful. This is her secret, how she does all this. This is her secret, how she is able to do all these things, plant this vineyard and do all this work and feed her family and do all these things and more things to come. This is her secret. She has the strength. And the loin represents the strength of God. Represents the strength of God, praise the Lord. That is what she's doing, is she has the strength of the Lord Jesus Christ. So here we go. And So 17, she girded her loins with strength and strengthened her arms. So she has strengthened her arms also. She strengthened her arms. That means that she is, you know, she's strong. She does physical things. Her arms are strong. And she perceiveth that her merchandise is good. Her candle goeth out not by night. It doesn't go out. So that means she always keep the light. Listen, it's very important to understand the Old Testament in the spiritual now as New Testament people. We can interpret this in a way that they did not even know, because this is a picture of Jesus. Jesus keeps the light on, because in darkness, that's where the enemy likes to go. We don't need to go there. Go to where Jesus is. He loves the light. Always keep the light on. Amen. Keep the light on. Hallelujah. That's a good song. Keep the light on. Okay. So we got the candle that does not go out. And a candle represents something you light and you keep going. We can have light without a candle, but I'm telling you, the light is warm from a candle. It's warm. It warms you. And also it glows in the whole room. One candle in darkness can make the whole room light up. It's amazing. That is a picture of Jesus. Jesus lights up the world when evil wants to destroy it. And Jesus came because he's the light of the world. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. 19, it says, she layeth her hands to the spindle, and her hands hold the distaff. Now, let me explain something about that. The distaff is a part of that. And flax. Okay, flax. I am sorry. Just a second. I got The flax is something I wanted to explain, but let's just skip that right now. We will go to this stuff, and that is a stick or a spindle, which the roll of the flax is well known. So what we got is a couple things here. Flax is the most important plant. So we talk about flax already, and what it is, I'm sorry, I gotta find where that flax is. Flax. I don't think I came to it yet. Yeah. Okay. So she stretches out her hand to the poor. Yea, she reaches forth her hands to the needy. This is a woman of God. And you know, on Mother's Day, think about how you can help and reach out to others. Think about how you can reach the nations. You know, even by praying and fasting and seeking God, God wants us to reach out to other people that way. Reach out to the world, but reach out to your neighbors, to your family. Okay, verse 20, she stretched out her hand to the poor, reached out her hands to the needy. She's not afraid of the snow for her household, for all her household are clothed with scarlet. Now, scarlet is red, and scarlet is from a tiny insect, and the red came out of that. So, in other words, it took much work to get this red, and she dressed her family in that. She honored her family by dressing them in red and scarlet. And she maketh herself coverings of tapestry. Tapestry is beautiful design on your clothes. Her clothing is silk and purple. So silk and purple. And purple is very expensive. Let me just look here a little bit. Be patient. Hallelujah. Oh, yeah. Okay. Verse 13. Let me go back to 13. I missed it completely. I'm sorry. She seeketh roe and flax. Flax, it is most important plant in the Bible time. It was used to make linen. All clothes were made by flax or wool. That's amazing. That is how they used to do it. Verse 13. And that is something, it took a lot of work to make this into something you could use. That's right. And so, we'll go back to verse 21. She's not afraid of the snow for a household, for all her household are clothed with scarlet. Now this scarlet is double thickness, they think. Double thickness, it's warm. And so her husband is known in the gates when he sitteth with the elders of the church. Now the gates represent the position of God. In every city back in the days, they would have gate that would lock the city at night. They would close the gates to keep out animals and to keep out people that were not good, enemies. And so people of high position would come and sit at those gates. Those gates is where her husband would go and sit. And he would have that position of protecting her and protecting the city. So it's an entry point where people come in. Well, what did she do? She had a husband that was faithful to protect the city, to protect the family. She was doing her job. This is a family that's doing what they're supposed to do. She make herself coverings with tapestry, her clothing silk and purple, and her husband known in the gates. He said among the elders of the land. Okay, verse 24. She maketh fine linen and selleth it, and deliver girdles into the merchant. Strength and honor are her clothing, and she shall rejoice in time to come. So, she does everything. She doesn't only do all these things, but she rejoices. What does that mean? That means that when you have blessings and you ask God for them, don't forget to also say thank you later. This is a blessing and a wonderful thing. Of she's not forgetting to be thankful. And so this is, she rejoices in time to come. Verse 26, it says, she opened her mouth with wisdom, and her tongue is the law of kindness. Now, There is so much to read in here, but she opened her mouth with kind wisdom. You know, as I'm older, I have learned to do that. You know, when you've been Christian for 40 some years, almost 50 years, and or even Christian 20 years maybe, the thing is, as we're walking with the Lord, if we are truly walking and He's our Lord and Savior, we get wiser and wiser. So hopefully that's the case. We all need to get wiser. And it says she opened her mouth with wisdom. Now, wisdom is wonderful, but we got to have understanding. And so she had that. The wisdom comes from understanding. Without understanding, she don't have wisdom, because wisdom by itself is not wisdom. You got to have understanding and then take with it wisdom. You know, wisdom, understanding, and be able to give good advice, to able to tell her children the right things, the wrong things. She's teaching them. You do this all the time in your church. You teach them, in your family, I hope. You teach your right from wrong. And this is one of the good things with this virus, is a lot of good coming out of it, where families are spending time with each other. So in 27 says, she looketh well to the ways of her household and eateth not the bread of idleness. This is talking about she makes sure she takes care of her household and she does not waste her time with idleness. You know what idleness for her is? Probably to go to sleep. In other words, she doesn't waste time. I have people, they play games on the phone. I don't have time to do that, but it's okay. But for me, I don't like to be idle. I like to be busy for God and busy doing good things, busy with my hands doing things that are good, right? Yeah, don't waste your time. There's so much to do for the Lord. And sure, He wants you to relax. He wants you to rest and enjoy a beautiful day. But remember, what we do for Christ will last. Everything else will pass. What we do for Jesus Christ, it will last forever. Everything else will pass. That's true. So always try not to be self-centered. Okay, we go now. Verse 28, a very good verse. Talking about her children. Her children arise up and call her blessed. Her husband also, and he praises her. So it's not praising like praising God. It's giving her praise and saying, you are a good wife. You are a good woman. May I encourage everyone here, please, be complimentary to your husband, to your wife, to your children. Give them praise when they do a good job. That helps so much. That is such a blessing and so important. And Jesus even did that when he talked with people. He would speak to them to praise and to lift them up and to say things that would bless them. So that's what she does. She does all these things. She does the physical work. She takes care of the family. She does a spiritual part of it. And 29 says, many daughters have done virtuously, but thou excellest them all. In other words, this lady did the best of anybody. She really did. She was fantastic. And favor is deceitful, and beauty is vain. But a woman that feareth the Lord, she shall be praise. Beauty is vain. Trust me, the older I get, the more I know that's true. And although God doesn't look at, He doesn't look like man does. Man looks at the outside, but God looks at the inside. But you know what? Our body is not meant to last forever. You know what is? Heaven. Our heavenly body, our spiritual body. If it wasn't for the sharing the gospel of Jesus Christ, I would love to just go to heaven right now. But because God has a job for all of us to tell people the good news, to tell the people about Jesus Christ, to tell people how we can be saved, how we can have a personal relationship with the Lord God, the God of the universe. Do you know who God is? He made the universe. There's billions and billions of universes out there. Do you know that? Not just one universe. Many, many. They said there's billions of them. There's like billions, I think, or whatever. Unending, we don't know how many. Billions. And yet our universe, we can't even go to the end of it. We can't, we don't have nothing we've ever made to travel that far. Nothing. Nothing. And yet in heaven, guess what? We're going to be instantly, wherever we think, we'll go here, we'll go there. We'll have the stars, we'll have the heavens. Jesus Christ is in the third heaven. It's in the Bible. And God and Jesus sitting on the right-hand side. Oh, we are going to be glory, 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 hallelujah, glory. It will be glory. I'm not sorry. I have goosebumps all over my body right now. I just feel the presence of God. Just let Jesus speak to you right now. Don't just hear my words, but let God speak to you. Everything I share with you is scriptural from the Bible. Hallelujah. He has a home for you in heaven. Isn't that wonderful? I know the Filipino life is different than America. It's hard. It's hard sometimes. I know right now I help a few people because they have nothing. And I know right now it's hard. It's very hard. For me, I have a freezer. I got food in it. I'm happy. Amen. But you know what? Let me say this from the heart. God knows what you're going through. And even if you have a very hard life, let me tell you this. God will never forsake you. He will never leave you. And even if you don't have things great, you know what? Here's a great promise. You will one day be with Jesus in heaven forever and ever. No matter what pain we go through on this earth, if people are persecuted, their heads are cut off, or they suffer, they have go hungry, you know what? It will be worth it all when we see Jesus. Hallelujah! It will be worth it all. Everything, all the tears will be gone. I cry like a baby sometimes. I got my mama's heart. My mama's not alive no more, but she had a wonderful heart. So my dad did too. But I love Jesus. I love to share the gospel of Jesus. And I love to see people find Jesus and say, wow, when I became a Christian, I became a Jesus person, people. A Jesus people. I preach the gospel on the streets and anywhere as I could. And I just love when I see somebody and all of a sudden they start understanding what you're saying. When you preach, it's not the words that will save somebody. It's God allowing them to have their eyes open spiritually. That is how people get saved. Not our wisdom, not our knowledge necessary. Oh, that's good. But God allows their eyes to be open. Hallelujah. That's why before you preach, before you share Jesus with someone, always pray, God, you have to speak to them. I can't do it. Help me to do the work you want me to do. Well, I tell you what, I'm adding a lot more to this message than I did this morning. But it's okay. I love this. God, I tell you, I love it because God tells me what to say as I'm talking. So all I got to do is hear his voice. Praise the Lord. Let me finish this here, and we're almost done. And thank you so much for being patient. I will go a little bit more, and if you want, and I don't want to go too far, but it'll be definitely under 45. And so, yes, talking about my daughters have done virtuously, and many daughters, it says, so that's many do virtuously. That's good. Virtuously is good, but doing virtuously all the time, that's better. So always try to be virtuously all the time. That means, listen, even if you're at an ocean, you're at the beach, you're at places where, you know, it's more easy to relax and forget things. You know, for me, I don't drink alcohol. I don't do those things the world does. I try not to. I'm not saying you can't, but what I'm saying is I try to focus my mind on the Lord all the time. You know, it's a good idea. It really is. And you know, Jesus loves a heart that's always focus on him. He really does. So let me read 30 and 31. Favor is deceitful and beauty is vain. Okay? So favor is deceitful. What is talking about? Let's say you get a king and he gets favor and everybody worships him. Oh, he's wonderful. That can be deceitful. You know why? Because it can go to the person's head. And also then give praise the person doesn't deserve. So be careful. Be careful. If everybody gives me too much praise, I have to stop them. I say, please, I'm just a man. I am just a man. I'm like any other man. I can sin. I can fall. I can not think right. I am a man, woman. And we got to be always let them real. Let people need to realize we got to be careful. We are human. God is God. One day we will be with him. And then, yes, that will be a glorious day. Oh, that will be glory for me. Oh, that will be glory for me. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. I love glory because that represents God. One day that will be glory for me. You know, I'll show you something right now. This is one of my favorite things I brought from the Philippines. And see, this represents a hard-working, beautiful Filipino people and a beautiful bananas. And I'll tell you something. God loves the Filipino people. God loves you, my dear sisters and brothers in the Lord. God loves your heart. God loves you. Let me read the last verse here. And so favor is deceitful, beauty is vain, but woman that feareth the Lord, she shall be praised. Give her of the fruit of her hands, and let her own works praise her in the gate. And in the gate represents God. Remember the God, her husband sits there. There's an entrance into the city. It represents the blessing. Either you get blessed or you don't get blessed. And when she stands in the gate, she gives the praise. This is worshiping the God right at the entrance of the tabernacle. So tabernacle talks about what we need to do as a woman. If you're on Mother's Day, I say again, honor God by being virtuous and by giving praise in the gate. So the gate can be any place. You can find a closet. You can find your bed. Kneel at your bed. I love kneeling at my bed. I love kneeling at the couch. I do that. That is places where I surrender my heart. It is so nice. It is so nice to surrender. Surrender. Don't try to be strong with God. Say, God, I surrender. Here I am. Let me be the woman of God you want me to be. Let me be the man of God you want me to be. So this is about it. And this is what we're building to. This is what we have, is to be men and women of God. Now, may I just say that Jesus wants to work in all of us, that through this time of the virus, I'm going to speak something on the virus, just going to take a couple minutes, but this virus is not by accident. God spoke to me about this before this happened to this extent. I knew about it, but I felt that God said to me that this was going to be something God was going to use. And I also recognize that God did not have a time where he woke up and he said, oh, I didn't know this was going to happen. Trust me in this when I tell you, when you have typhoons, you have tornadoes, you have this virus, Chinese virus, the 19, it is not by accident. The Filipino people, I believe, are closer to God than America because you go through things that are very scary. I mean that honestly. You have floods. I'm telling you, I know many friends there. And you can actually thank the Lord, because when God brings these things, it changes the heart, your heart. And so we need to not try to have these things happen, but we need to say, God, help us, Lord, in this time to trust you. Help us not to be fearful, because this is the vision God gave me. This is what God gave me a picture of. that during this time, just remember this, please, remember this. God showed me a picture of standing up. And during this time of the virus, and everybody's so scared, that we need to put on Jesus. And when we do this, and we have no fear, rather we have joy, and people can see we're rejoicing, people will say, wow, this person represents Jesus. They will say, this is what Jesus looks like. Because we will have no fear. Isn't that wonderful? We'll have no fear during this time. So trust God. And remember, the devil comes as a roaring lion. But actually, he has no teeth. He only pretends he can bite you and chew you up. He can only do you harm if you don't trust God. That is all I have. And I hope that is a blessing. And let me just say, I want to pray at the end here. And I don't know if you want, if there's special needs, I have anointing oil. I can anoint you on the screen. We can pray for one another if you want to do that. But let me just finish, Father, in Jesus' name. Let this message, Lord, speak to every heart. That is not from Mark LeBrandy, Lord, it's from Jesus Christ. These words are from the Bible, Lord. And Lord Jesus, thank you for my dear Filipino friends. My family, I love them, Lord. I love each woman, each man, young kids, whoever is here, Lord. I pray your blessing upon their houses, their homes. And Father, that we will remember the church, the building is not the church. It's the people that are the church. They can go in the building and make it a church, but hallelujah. The church is the people. We are the church as never before. Hallelujah. And through the internet, the church has expanded like it's never done in history. Never in history has the world done the same thing all at once. So, Lord, thank you for this. And thank you, Lord, for your word. In Jesus' name. And let me just say one more thing, and that is, this is not the end time virus, but it is preparing us for it. It is getting hearts ready. We need to think about Jesus. Stop being so busy and think about the family. Amen. Amen.
Hallelujah. Praise God. Hallelujah. So, atong tagaan na dahong palakpak ang ginawa'y soon.
Amen. Praise the Lord.
Giving the word of empowerment, the word of God.